Today, my name is Jonder Hart Marino. I'm from English 1B of the BPSC Balangan campus. And for today's video, we're going to talk about the understanding of the human sexual response and the basic biology of sexual behavior. So let's first of all tackle, what is the human sexual response? The sexual response cycle alludes to the grouping of physical and enthusiastic changes that happen as an individual gets to be sexually stimulated and partakes in sexually fortifying exercises, including intercourse and masturbation. Knowing how your body reacts amid each stage of the cycle can improve your relationship and assist you to pinpoint the cause of sexual brokenness. So, human sexual response is the subsequent process of how an individual feels when engaging to any sexual exercise, and as said here, including intercourse and masturbation. So, phases of sexual response. According to Johnson and Master of 1966, sexual response follows a regular pattern consisting of four phases, and those are arousal, plateau, orgasm, and resolution. So let me elucidate each and every single phase of sexual response. First is the arousal phase. The arousal phase is a subjective sense of sexual pleasure. The physiological sign in males is penile tumescence, or erection, and a vasoconjunction to female leads to vaginal lubrication and nipple erection. So, at arousal phase, or excitement phase, is where both men and women get sexually excited to any sexual exercise they're going to engage. Arousal lasts for a few minutes or several hours. The next phase is the plateau phase. The plateau phase is a brief period of time before the orgasm. It is the body's preparation for orgasm. Plateau is the extension to the brink of orgasm and the intensified stage of phase 1, which is the arousal. The third stage is the orgasm phase. The orgasm phase is an intense, highly pleasurable experience. When this phase is reached, rhythmic muscular contractions occur in the genitals. In male, the contraction expels semen, a fluid containing sperm, a process called ejaculation. For women and men, breathing and heart rates reach a maximum. So, orgasm, or the climax of the sexual response, unlike arousal, orgasm only lasts for only a few seconds. And the last phase is the resolution. The resolution stage is where the decrease of arousal, particularly in male, happens. Genitals resume their unaroused state and shape. Blood pressure, breathing, and heart rate return to normal. Resolution is the phase of returning to the normal stage of functioning. Erected body parts return to their previous size and color. So those are the four phases of sexual response that happens in human beings. Let's move on to the basic biology of sexual behavior. Human sexual behavior is complex and complicated. Thus, it is not at all different from other species. To illustrate, men's sexual behavior can occur at any time by being aroused to certain stimuli. At puberty, the testes begin to secrete androgens, male sex hormones, which produce secondary sex characteristics like growth of bodily hair and change in the tone of voice, like my voice, it's quite deep. Female sexual behavior starts at puberty, where the two ovaries begin to produce estrogens and progesterone, female sex hormones. This stage of puberty for female occurs in cyclical manner, where also brought changes, while for a non-human period of ovulation is only when the ovulation occurs to the female species is receptive to sex. So, we have to tackle what are the human reproductive systems. So, human reproductive system is an organ system by which reproduces and bear live offspring. It requires the union between the male and the female reproductive system to which carries out to produce another life form. Provided that all organs are present, human reproductive system works from the release of egg cell from the female reproductive organ to the fertilization of sperm cells to the conception up to the giving birth of the baby and eventually to the return of the female physical body to the original state. So, these are the male reproductive system and female reproductive system. These are the parts that are within the male reproductive system. The first is the testes. Testes is the most important part of male reproductive organ. It is the source of spermatozoa, male germ cell. Second is the scrotum. It is a sac of skin where the two testes are enveloped, directly below and outside of the abdomen. The third is the prostate glands. It is a gland that carries out both urine and seminal fluid. It is connected by sperm ducts from sperm ducts joining into single tube called urethra. Urethra then leads to the outside of the body through penis. It is the passage of both urine and semen. So The fourth one is the penis. It is where the ejaculation occurs by sending sperm cell from testes and secreted out. The last one is the sperm. It is a male gamete, one that is necessary for the egg to develop and become a baby. So without sperm cell, there is no life form. So this is the female reproductive system. First one is the ovary. It is a pair of small oval organs which produces ova, ovum, female germ cells. Thousands of ova will mature and will be taken up to the fallopian tube through the uterus by the time of puberty. And the second one is the fallopian tube, a pair of thin tubes that leads from ovaries to the uterus. And then third, the uterus. Womb, it is a hollow, pear-shaped, elastic muscular structure where fertilized ovum, or zygote, develops into a baby. And the last part is the vagina. It is a tube leading to outside of the body through an opening called the vulva.